Video game analytics have seen large advancements in the past years. The industry has access to excessively growing data sets. Data science and machine learning gets more and more efficient and usable, and companies are willing to invest in techniques that pay off. On the other hand, academia has also produced very powerful analytics tools for games recently. So we have insights for the industry, and we have insights for specific academic interests. But what about the actual player? There are a few game analytics platforms that revolve around player interests out there, but even they rarely follow a player-driven design cycle, let alone that this development process would be scientifically documented. And yet, I hold the opinion that the role of the player is the most important one when developing games, marketing games, and analyzing games. Game design should follow player experience, player interests, and player requirements. So I'm convinced that it's a fruitful endeavor to listen to players when it comes to analytics as well, which we will showcase in the next minutes and this paper, Player-Driven Game Analytics in the Case of Guild Wars 2. Guild Wars 2 was released about 10 years ago and has grown to be one of the most popular MMORPGs of our time. In this work, we focus on its endgame player versus environment content, which mainly revolves around defeating challenging bosses with 5 to 10 players. This gives us a very comparable environment for analytics, as most players are on a similar equipment and attribute level. B, we have access to a large spectrum of player skill, from expert players up to novices that just started raiding, and everything in between, which helps us studying game analytics for everyone's needs. And C, we can operate on the many years of gameplay history already, from a large pool of unique players, which is of course necessary when you want to produce valid and high quality analytics. This kind of team-based PvE content is above that quite generalizable for most MMOs out there. And some of the analytics that we establish are arguably also usable for competitive esports or PvP situations. So how do we approach building a platform that suits the player's needs? The answer is, of course, participatory development, and we follow the straightforward approach of building up a target group sample, assessing their needs, implementing features, and re-evaluating if this can answer the kind of questions they're looking for. We started with recruiting people from Rage training groups to implement what features would be important for novice players, and on the other hand, we contacted some highly skilled speedrun guilds to investigate what kind of insights they need on their end. We asked them to spread the word and quickly attracted a lot of interested users. To skip to the current day, after 2 years of participatory development, people uploaded more than 6 million unique combat logs that display frame-to-frame atomic behavior, which makes up about 2 million hours of playing time. We have data from over 180,000 unique players that they voluntarily contributed, and in the last time, over 6,000 active users of the platform. So let's jump right into the outcomes of the cycle and see what themes of questions arose that players are interested in. First of all, there's of course the desire to replay combats the players already fought in detail and report all the decisions and behaviors of a single fight. For this, we can luckily draw on Elite Insights, which is a partnering tool that produces these replays. Most of the players have used this feature before, so like 77%, and in the last month, about 3,500 users utilized it per day. Before we go into detail, I first want to paint the bigger picture of the remaining needs and the requirements of the player community. There are about 50 bosses of the game that we support, and of course, a bigger question than single fights is, how can I approach a boss in general, or how viable is my profession or any class of the game against a particular boss? Aggregating data from up to hundreds of thousands of combats per boss, we calculate distributions, medians, and progressions for every class and build of the game, and display them in various charts. Viability can be quantified in the damage per second that they are able to deliver, in the quality of buffs and boons they can support, the contribution to the efficiency of playing the boss's phases and mechanics, and more. And every point in these box plots, for example, is linked to the replay report that you just have seen, so that interested users can directly investigate performances and compare them to their own. This feature, what we call encounter analysis, is used by most users per day, because there's no way to get these viability insights in-game or in any quantified way out of our platform. This, of course, entails the next question, on which bosses can I improve my gameplay? A lot of players are interested in self-regulated learning, improving themselves and comparing their performances to what other players of the same class have managed to produce. This, of course, excels as players ask for a leaderboard to climb the ladder of how well somebody plays his class, which has become one of the leading motivations to get insights from the platform and earn some bragging rights. A more general question would be, which professions or classes are used and have been used how often in relationship to others? Since we have data from the past 5 or 6 years now, we can display trends in game balancing by illustrating which classes are super popular right now and which are not played by anybody anymore. Apart from that, we also have a peer network of players, as they wanted to see how the players they play with are connected, which groups are forming, and as this again is a team-based multiplayer environment, it is not obvious how to construct the best compositions of groups for any given boss. So in the group composition features, users can assess what are the most frequent comps per boss, and on the other hand, what are the most efficient comps and why they are often different. Eventually, we also have certain interests that focus on individual questions. Did I or my group improve in the last weeks? How does a skill rotation unfold its damage over time? Or did my own damage improve over the last hours of training or grinding a boss or anything? For which we all added particular analytics features. You already see a certain color coding here, and this is what we've identified as greater themes after all these features came together. Aggregate analytics that give general insights about the current state of the game. Individual analytics that focus on self-improvement and desires to use our tool as a social platform to publish their best performances, compare them to others, fight for ranks, and see how the community is connected. Of course, there's a certain overlap between these categories, but these are the three general trends why players use our platform now. Having implemented all of these features, we looked into how people actually make use of them in combination and how this can answer questions important to the community. As you can see in this journey map, which is explained in more detail in the paper, users most often start with encounter analysis or log analysis directly. But there are certain journey trends that protrude. To give you a better picture how particular features look like and how people make sense out of it, we focus on one example of popular trends here. So one of the main trends in aggregate analytics would be, what is the current state of the game balance? Where people like to start on the popularity page. And at the time when we were writing this paper, there was a very clear trend that the Mechanist class became more and more popular, up to a point where every third player played a Mechanist, even though there are over 30 classes to choose from. So players go and look why this is the case. The group composition page gives us a very clear image. It is used in almost any comp during that time, and even contributes more efficiency than any other profession, so it makes the boss kill faster. And yet, the way fastest kills do not use a single Mechanist. Let's investigate that further. At least for the first boss, Mechanists seem to produce the highest median damage per second values over all classes. This alone is of course a noteworthy cause why people pick the Mechanist over anything else, but some Bladesong players, as you can see, reach even higher damage numbers and therefore better efficiency. As all the pages are linked, we can click on one of those dots in the distribution and immediately can replay the combat, see the strategy, and follow the rotations that these players executed in order to reach these overwhelming performances. With some in-game knowledge, players can already infer why getting high damage scores on a Mechanist is way more likely than getting high damage scores on a Bladesong, because they have a drastically easier playstyle. To make that clear to today's audience here, we use another feature of the platform, rotation comparison, to compare the best possible action loop for a Bladesong and that of a Mechanist, which comes out way less complex, with less subloops and more forgiving. Long story short, as the general trend of player opinions shows, that a more complex playstyle should go along with higher rewards of damage potentials, the developers followed player demands and nerfed this class accordingly, while our platform delivered empirical quantifications accessible to inform everyone. While I would love to get more into details about all of the features or give more use case examples now, I have to wrap it up already and state the bigger contributions of this work. We hereby presented a large-scale participatory development endeavor of multiple years and thousands of voices to be heard. We constructed a game analytics platform for players and academia to study and hope to bring players, academia, and the industry closer together. And we, of course, aggregated a huge database for which we established convenient APIs, already working with several GoodWiz 2 projects, and are happy to collaborate with your research interests as well. Don't hesitate to reach out. Our players, of course, love to spend time with our platform. They highlight the understanding and insights that it can bring, and that it encourages players to self-improve and compete. Apart from that, it has been discussed by the most influential streamers of the game. We built a plugin that is also adopted by players already and shows you some of the most important features while playing. We have a Discord integration that announces new records, and we use the data of the platform to answer new research questions, like how spatiotemporal movement strategies can be analyzed, how players can optimize their in-game skill rotations using a custom game simulator and AI-assisted search technology, how to model atomic behavior of individual players in the context of GoodWiz 2, or how to reduce the entry barrier even further to allow players to use natural language interfaces to ask for general questions, stats, plots, or analytics. Thanks for listening, and feel free to reach out for any questions or collaborations.